So during drought years, California becomes more dependent on groundwater, but that groundwater hasn't always been well maintained. Water managers are looking for new ways to boost their supply. In today's Forecasting Our Future story, KCRA 3 meteorologist Heather Waldman shows us how farmers can help out with this.
Agriculture is hugely important to California's economy. The industry also uses a majority of the state's groundwater supply. But new research shows how farm fields just like this can be used to help replenish that supply through a process called AGMAR.
AGMAR stands for Agricultural Managed Aquifer Recharge. So managed aquifer recharge is a term we use for intentionally placing more water into groundwater aquifers than would naturally occur from rainfall.
The practice of pumping surface water into underground storage isn't new. Sacramento water managers have been building a groundwater bank for decades. It's a good start, but there's a lot of water that needs to be replaced.
The amount of groundwater overdraft that we have accumulated over the last couple of decades is exceeding 160 million acre feet, which is about 1.3 times Lake Tahoe.
And big storms are coming through less frequently. So the area collecting that surface water needs to be maximized.
And this is where farmland will come in handy. We have over 8 million acres of farmland. You know, if you flood just 1 million of that with, you know, 2 feet of water or so, you could put a lot of water away.
That can only happen if there's extra rain. Careful planning is a must. In the Tulare Irrigation District, farmers register their fields ahead of the rainy season.
They also provide incentives to farmers, so they actually get a reimbursement, like, you know, a certain amount of water for free or a cash payment.
Farms with flood irrigation systems would be the most efficient at pumping in and storing excess water.
They should also have soils that have a fairly high sand content. Sandy soils have the advantage they can move water fairly quickly.
That's key in minimizing the risk to crops. Unplanted fields would be best to minimize those economic losses. Despite some risk, the idea is growing in popularity.
There's definitely quite a bit of interest among the growers in the Central Valley. We just need the water.
Dalka says that before we rely too heavily on farmland groundwater recharging, we need to better understand the potential contamination effects. That's because any farm that uses a nitrogen fertilizer could leach nitrates into the water as it's going into the ground, and that could have potential health effects. For KCRA 3 News, I'm meteorologist Heather Waldman.